Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to spot these Famicom to NES converters in these older NES games. There's a couple of things that you want to look for when you find these guys, and there's some telltale indicators on which cartridges to look for. If you notice here, we have a copy of Gyromite and Trojan, as well as Kung Fu. These here we'll show you how to determine which ones might have a converter in it and which ones don't. The first thing you want to look for when you're looking at these games here is you want to look for games that have no tabs on the top of the cartridge. And that there goes hand in hand with the back part here. It will indicate that it is actually a 5-screw setup. And some games have them, some games don't, just by comparison. I do have Kung Fu here, and these are a lot more common, where you see the tabs actually on the top. Just by comparison, you can see the two there. This one here will indicate that it's a 3-screw, so that would off the back tell you that this one here will not have a converter in it. Another thing you want to look at when you find one that has a 5-screw is the bottom part where the cartridge actually connects to the system. And basically, you want to look at the pins, and depending on how the pins are set up, that will determine whether or not you're looking at a converter or if you're actually looking at a PCB for the game board. And when you look at these pins, like from the top part down, if you put it in the light, your pins should look like this. Basically, you'll have all the pins that go from left to right, they would be like that, right? And then on the right side of each pin, holding it with the top side facing towards you, should have like a little offset pin, a dog tooth if you will, facing the right side of the pin, so it'll be off center. Now if you find one that has a pin like that and they're consistent where the dog tooth is in the middle, like exactly in the middle, then that would be not a converter. So those are not the ones you're looking for. So basically, you want to look for a five screw setup with the pins like this. And just to show you, I do have a five screw setup here, but this one does not have the I guess you say the offset tooth. So let's go ahead and open this guy up here. And if you can see there, yeah, all the pins are in the middle, and obviously this does not have a converter inside. This would be on Trojan. Now, Kung Fu does have the pins that are offset, but of course it's the 3-screws, so it wouldn't be the combination of the two. So again, you don't have the converter here. If you notice these are offset going left, it's because I have it upside down. But, yeah, that's what you would be looking for, but you would have to look for a 5-pin setup, the combination of the two, in order to find whether or not it has a converter in it or not. And I know a lot of them can be found in Gyromite, but there are other titles, so just based on that setup, I have the 5-screw layout and also the offset pins. Again, they're going to the left here, but I have it where the base is facing towards us. The bottom is facing towards us, so they'll be going the other direction, of course. And yeah, another way you could determine these, if you do have another copy of the same type of game, these obviously feel a little bit heavier towards this middle area here where it says caution or what. That's because of the converter itself. If you notice these guys here, just by comparison, you will not have quite as much mass in that area, so that's also another way to find if you have a converter. If you're really good about weighing things in your hand and determining a different type of weight in, from one to the next, then this would be another indicator that there's definitely a converter in there. But yeah, this is a converter itself. It would be this black part here all the way down. And this here is the 60 to 72 pin converter, and then this is the part that actually, of course, connects to the NES system. The board that you have on the top here, this is the Famicom board. And just to show you, we have another one here. They're not always the same as far as the converters go. If you notice, We do have one here that the black portion itself, the pin converter, is actually taller than this one here. Another thing I wanted to note is that it does have bridged pins with resistors here, while as this one here does not. Another thing I want to note is the way that the boards face. If you're going to put in a Japanese game, usually they're facing downward when you put them in the NES. So, it could be... I guess you could say it's somewhat backwards when you use it as a converter. And another thing you want to note here is you might have to shave off these ends here if you're going to use it as a universal converter, just because the cartridges don't slide all the way down. But yeah, this is actually a legitimate Gyromite board, and for some reason it's facing the other direction, and I do have another one here that is also considered as Gyromite, and this one here has a different kind of setup. Whereas this one has the soldered ICs on, well, they're on the back part here. Yeah, basically that's what you would look for, like if you found these out, you know, out and about. And tall tale indicators to finding one of these guys if you want to play Famicom games on your NES. So I thought it would be helpful to show you guys, you know, the ways that I go about looking for them, at least. But yeah, thanks again for watching, guys. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.